This video has provided a supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the composition of functions. So the composition of functions works something like this. Let's say I've got two functions, f and g. And function f is f of x equals 3x plus 4. And g of x equals 2x minus 5. And then I have a notation that looks like this. I've got a parentheses, and inside the parentheses I've got an f for function f, and that's followed by a small open circle, and then I've got a g for function g, and that's the end of the parentheses, and then I may have a parentheses after that that contains a number, like a 3, or maybe just contains a variable like an x. This is a composition of functions. The notation is read as f compose g of 3. And the easiest way to understand composition of functions is going to be to convert this notation into a notation that looks like this. F of g of 3. Now be careful with parentheses. If I have function f and it's f of something, it's going to be followed by parentheses, and it was f of g. So that g is going to go into inside the parentheses. But it was g of 3, so the 3 has to go into parentheses after the g. Now, looking at this, what we've actually got is a function of a function. Function f of function g of 3. If we understand that, it gets fairly easy to solve. Working from the innermost parentheses, I'm going to take that g of 3 and figure out what it is. I know that g of x is 2x minus 5. So g of 3 would mean that I'm going to take that 3 and put it wherever I have an x in my g of x. So g of 3 is going to be, let's see, g of 3 is going to be 2 times 3, since I originally had 2 times x, minus 5. And 2 times 3 is 6, minus 5. 6 minus 5 is 1. So g of 3 is 1. Now I can rewrite that f of g of 3 by replacing the g of 3 with a 1. So it's going to be just f of 1. Well, I know what function f is. Function f is f of x equals 3x plus 4. So I'm just going to take, if I want f of 1, I'll put a 1 in wherever the x is. So that's going to mean it's 3 times 1 plus 4. 3 times 1 is 3 plus 4 is 7. So f of 1 is 7, which means f of g of 3 is 7, which means f compose g of 3 is 7. Now I'm going to do this a second time. I'm going to reverse the order of my functions. I'm going to do g compose f of 3. Let's see what happens. So g compose f of 3 could be rewritten as g of f of 3. Starting from my inner parentheses, I want to find out what f of 3 is. So let's see. F of x is 3x plus 4. So f of 3 is going to be 3 times 3 plus 4. 3 times 3 is 9 plus 4. 9 plus 4 is 13. So f of 3 is 13. That means I can rewrite my composition as g of 13. Now all I have to do is find out what g of 13 is. Okay, well, g of x is 2x minus 5. So g of 13 would be 2 times 13 minus 5. 2 times 13 is 26. So that's 26 minus 5. And 26 minus 5 is 21. So g of 13 is 21, which means that g of f of 3 is 21. And g compose f of 3 is 21. Okay? Now I've done the same process. I've used the same functions, but I've reversed the order of the functions. When you reverse the order of the functions, you may get two totally different answers. There are some situations under which you won't, but you can't be sure of that until you do some checks and some tests. So don't assume that reversing the order is going to give you the same answer. There's a very good chance it won't. So the order of these two functions is going to be important. Okay, so that's basically what the composition of functions is about. Take care. I'll see you next time.